Hey, so since we are talking and I'm just discussing a variety of things and showing you just different things I'm working on, studying on, going over my some of my old notes. Last idea was what is wisdom? And you know, from the book of Job, you will learn a lot of things, not only what wisdom is, as Father God Almighty himself says, just alone to depart from evil is an understanding. What does this mean? Hi, my name is Anna or Anya. Welcome to my channel. I'm so glad that you're here. Thank you for subscribing and thank you for giving me thumbs up. I know that you will because you're awesome and I love you. And I'm not going to be cornered in, or my brothers and sisters. We will discuss things openly. This is why we are in the United States of America. We believe in the Constitution. We love our country, but we're not blind to what's happening. We live in the last days, and part of what's taking place on, of course, YouTube or Google, the different types of censorships is part of the system, beast system, right? But I'm here to talk to you over just a few things, and I'm gonna talk about my dream. From now many years ago, if you will, not many years ago, 3 or 4 years ago, I think it's 3 years ago, please read the book of Job again. If you're being assaulted by Leviathan, I repeat, read chapter 40 of 41, chapter 41 of Job. That is if you're being specifically assaulted by Leviathan. Yes. I wanted to. I wanted to let you know that even when Job was severely assaulted and attacked, and he has allowed himself to for a rebellious tongue, because through words when we go and get rebellious, right? Right now, during the holiday season, so-called holiday season, spirit of rebelliousness. And bunch of other spirits like idolatry, spirits of confusion, spirit of denial will, and many others will creep up on you. They know it's their turn. Just then, so this the alligator spirit, I call him because he looks like an alligator. He has the face. He has the face of an alligator, and like a human body. Like limbs, like human body. Okay, that's you see them in pharaohs, right? On the Egyptian walls or side of pyramids or certain temples. That's the spirit of slender. Alligator spirit, evil spirit, the demon is a demon of slender, which right now is working overtime against us. It is on this, I told you, ever revolving hamster wheel upon which each Christian is, whether you lukewarm, whether you 100% for the Lord, depending on what your level of walk with Jesus Christ of Nazareth is. For the Father God Almighty, remember the only way to Him and to heaven is through Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, period. And yes, we're about to be raptured because yes, Father has already told me that the dead in Christ are about to rise up. The next card, I've been seeing double X's everywhere. X. I know Sister Lisa of Sabbath Seekers. She had a dream, I think it was on June 4th, 2017, where she saw very specific numbers. And I think it was she saw, I'm looking now for that notebook. Oh, it's behind me. She saw as follow. So I'm going to show you, I have notes. Okay. So the notes are from, she said it was, excuse me, it was November 25, 2017. So soon, we're coming up on the 3rd year anniversary of that dream that Sister Lisa of Sabbath Seeker had. And it looked as follow. Look at the numbers. XX468 plus 4 equals XX472. That's all she saw. So I looked up these numbers, and number 4 means fruit, and 468 basically means like a rock, like father of the rock, father god of rock. And 472 means El Shabbat in Hebrew, which means God or Yahweh is an oath. So I suggest you, brothers and sisters, go pray about this and see for yourself what this means. Because I believe that to Sister Lisa, she didn't know what it meant. She was asking people to what it means. And I've been trying to contact her and tell her what this means, but I had no luck. And the one time I contacted her, she told me she had no time to really keep in touch with anyone. And she does a lot of work. I understand that, respect that. At this point in time, Father has called all of us to keep our eyes on Jesus, right? So this is what I know for a fact this means, brothers and sisters. This is amazing. I believe, what if on the 30th year anniversary, basically anytime between now or that so-called 30th year anniversary, maybe since her dream, or soon enough, or soon thereafter, this means that the dead in Christ will rise up. Father told me that a week ago, that and 2 weeks ago, confirmed with me twice, that the dead in Christ, those dead from of long ago, who were his prophets, who were his saints, from of all, disciples, will rise from the dead. Do you understand? And your family members, they will rise from the dead just to be raptured. And then right after that, of course, babies get raptured, and children of a very specific, to up to specific age, where, you know, we as parents are responsible to teach our children, you know, about Jesus, about the name of Jesus. I taught my daughter as much as I could, and biblical stories as much as I could, but I taught her how to pray. She tells me she prays, but it's probably, you know, how an 11-year-old can be. It's probably very quick and brief. I hope that she's serious about it. And that at that age, you know, our children put up a lot of drama in front, especially our American spoiled children. I'm very strict overall. I expect a lot because I give a lot of respect. But overall, I'm very flexible. You can tell me anything. I'm not going to judge you. I'm not going to, level you with the ground. I am forgiving, but if I have forgiven you more than 490 times than the New Testament, Jesus in the New Testament commands us, and I've forgiven you maybe as much as 7,007 times, you, my brother or sister, who happens to be intercepted by the enemy, and you, a witch or warlock or wizard, and you assaulted me or my little daughter, or you've raped her or me, or and tortured us physically, no, you know, I still forgive you. But at this point, it is all passed on to my Heavenly Father, God Almighty. And he, of course, passed it on to Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And then this is being passed on to cruel messengers at this point, because I'm not going to be dealing with your assaults and over just what? You conjure up devils, demons, witches, warlocks, and you asking them only to become spies and spy for you, but they come and literally steal money. They rob us of money. They rob $200 from me. I'm not tripping. I know how much money I had. There was only me and nobody else in the room but those demons. Do you understand? Yes. And they can rape, they can sexually molest and harass, they can give nightmares, they can do all kinds of things. They some don't do anything at all. Like I said, it depends what still the enemy's agenda is for you. If the enemy wants you then to be, you thinking you're just sending the devil out to spy through an, or it's, you think it's you through an astral projection, check your head again. It's not you. It's never you living your spirit. It's the demonic entities that possess your body that leave, and they can make up something that they make you will believe that they're showing you they saw or you are seeing live when it isn't what they're seeing. Do you understand? They can also falsify easily by creating, I call them, their own cartoons. Those are the ones, if you're getting visions from a demon, that's also false. They can make you think that someone is coming against you when they're not. They can easily do that. I've seen them do this with me. I know what I'm talking about. This is because I was intercepted, don't forget, by the enemy for 4 years. And I was in a delusion. I knew that it was the enemy, but I didn't know what kind of the enemy, because they were posing as interdimensional aliens of some sort. Come back for more.